Good morning. It's breakfast time. It's 6:30 on Friday, the 17th of August. A very good morning to you.
Five divers, cameramen and technicians, Mr. Gimbal, who's in partnership with his wife, started an operation to salvage some of the liner's contents. For 35 days, working from their base in an underwater pressure chamber, they probed into the tangle of wreckage and eventually found what they were looking for.
Want to hear something? Drew's got his hand on the safe. His hand is on the safe. He's got his hand on the dial.
Since then, in an effort to preserve its contents, the safe has been kept in a salt water tank in the New York Aquarium. And while it rested there, Peter Gimbal was making a film about his adventure with the sunken Italian liner. He vowed the safe would not be opened until the night his film was shown on television around the world.
On Thursday night, August 16th, the entire world will witness the opening of the bank safe from the Andrea Doria, live on camera.
A fortnight ago, two British experts flew out to America to free the safe's locking mechanism. And a New York locksmith was charged with the final task of opening the rust-covered door. If the safe cracker does his job, we'll know at last what is actually in the Andrea Doria's safe. Damp banknotes, precious stones maybe, or perish the thought, absolutely nothing at all. At the start, a rather dangerous technical hitch.
Okay, there you go!
A special liquid that slowly forces objects to the surface without damaging them had been fed into the murky water. The first find wasn't immediately recognizable. It looked rather like a burnt roast, but turned out on closer examination to be a wad of banknotes. At regular intervals, more and more floated up, providing a field day for a group of experts who'd gathered to examine them. The operation had only been going on for a few minutes when there was a torrential downpour. Someone speculated it was the curse of the Andrea Doria. Armed security guards mingled with the crowd. They didn't have much to worry about. The loot would have been difficult to spend. But Mr. Gimbal seemed relieved the safe actually contained something, even if it wasn't valuable jewelry or gold bullion.
I was thrilled and amazed. I never expected to find whole bills in there. Never. I would have bet you 1,000 to 1 we'd never find one whole bill after 28 years on the bottom.
So what did you learn from all of this?
That paper's a lot tougher than you think.
And so one of the mysteries of the Andrea Doria had been solved. But maybe no one will ever know what's in the luxury liner's other safe. It's still there, 200 feet or so beneath the sea. And Mr. Gimbal says he has no plans for another treasure hunt.
Ooh, what's in the other safe, eh? Ooh. Up in air, Captain Sensible has been the guest. And I wonder what he's up to now, Guy. What's he going to be doing?
I think that's a pretty good question as well. Captain, you've been with us all morning. Oh, look. Well, clearly you've brought your fans with you as well. What are you up to at the moment? We've talked about your past quite a lot. What about your future?
The only thing really I've got going at the moment is the single, There Are More Snakes Than Ladders, and an album called The Power of Love. Because, you know, I'm such a lovable bloke, I mean. You know, I'm always helping old ladies across the road and things like that. I mean...
Take him anywhere, every mother's son. Tell me about the video, because I mean, the videos are an important part in pop music today, anyway.
Yeah, but I'd rather talk about breakfast. You said this is called breakfast time, right? Yeah. And where's my breakfast?
Your breakfast? Well, you've got cold fish on the floor, but I think we can... Oh, dear. Not again. No. That is not... Oh, they said take up serious journalism, young man, they said. Thank you very much indeed. Are you going to tell me about your video, or am I going to have to
my
eat
video,
you
yes.
fish?
This is, the worst thing in the world, right, was, I was completely unprepared for... The director said, OK, you've nearly finished, Captain, but now you've got to jump into a vat of paint. And I said, a vat of paint? Yeah. Why? Because it's like supposed to be like a breakfast bowl full of milk. And the only thing they could make look like milk was paint.
Guns.
Poor old Captain. the things you do to sell records. But it is a good record. And it's a good video as well.
Can people expect to see you around the country, I mean, on tour and things like that, anytime in the near future?
Hopefully the Damned will be touring sometime later in the year, and we might have a record out as well. Mom, good luck to the Damned, I say.
Absolutely.
Well, good luck to you lot as well.
Shall we see... somebody's actually brought a Captain
this is
Sensible
actually,
post...
This is actually Burns country, and my name's Burns.
Yeah,
isn't that weird?
Yes, yes, but, wonderful.
I'm thinking of calling it Sensible Country now.
Well, I think it's high time we had a look at that video.
The fish stinks.
The video for the song More Stakes Than Ladders.
Three, two, you vote for me.
Wonderful stuff. I hope it does well for you. Terrific, terrific.
Thank you, boss.
A beautiful day.
It's a lovely day today.
The weather's
gorgeous. Shall we discover what the weather's going to be like for the rest of the day? Francis,
cracking day in most parts. Perhaps a little thunderstorm in the far southeast, but I doubt it. The fog will soon clear down there. A lovely day. And what is that dorsal fin doing out there in the bay?
Well, Glinch and Mink and
Shark.
Somebody's mother.
Somebody's mother.
It's coming closer.
Now, you live up here, but how often do you actually get up to your flat up here?
Oh, once in a blue moon. Yeah, once in a blue moon. It's the pressure of work.
Oh, well, it's been a lovely place to live.
I know. I mean, I'd like more leisure time, but the breakfast time programme had other ideas about it.
What do you do in your time off? Do you get any time off?
Not very much, but I try to avoid that stuff.
He's being unkind about my fish.
It smells.
Don't be rude about
horrible.
His fish. Not at all.
It was lovely last night.
Do you have any hobbies apart from keeping your rabbit?
I play cricket.
Do you really?
And I'm very upset. They should have called me up because I was needed. I mean, against the West Indies, I couldn't have done any worse than the rest of them, could I, really?
Oh, don't be mean.
Being a captain as well.
That's right. Do you think you're Britain's new fast bowler? I mean, the old action is there, is it?
Yeah, I could knock a few heads off.
Don't you think we ought to end on a song?
That's a good idea. You're the musical director of this. What song do you think we should sing?
Oh, I do like to be beside the sea.
Okay, I'll go with that.
Right,
oh, I do like
you'll to be join us, won't you, ladies and gentlemen?
One, two.
Oh, I do like to be beside the seaside. Oh, right. I do like to be beside the sea. And the young girls aside, I will rum from pum with the brass band going tiddly om pom pom. Oh, I do like to be beside the seaside.
Final farewell to air. Let's have a last look at the news headlines. Car maker John DeLorean is celebrating a famous courtroom victory. A Los Angeles jury has acquitted him of all drug charges, but DeLorean still faces investigation by federal authorities on fraud counts. In Staffordshire, there's been trouble at the Littleton pit. 10 people were arrested during a night of violence. And West Belfast has also seen more trouble overnight, with loyalist gunmen firing on police patrols and disturbances in which 2 policemen were hurt.
Thank you. All there is time left now is to say thank you very much to Ned Sherrin, who's been our guest reviewer of the papers and guest of the day. What are you going to do immediately now?
I'm going to try and rehearse those 3 poor people who've got to try and learn all those steps in the ratepayers' aisle ante. We've got a heavy course of rehearsals with them and understudy calls. Then I'm off to Worthing to see The Sound of Music with Edmund Hockridge. And I'm going to Chichester tomorrow to see The Merchant of Venice and Maggie Smith in The Way of the World. Then I'm back on Sunday to see Lena Horne on Sunday night, and then more rehearsals on Monday morning. I'm doing Start the Week on Monday morning with Daley Thompson, no less.
Where would you be without the theatre and radio and television? You love it, don't you?
I think I'd probably be in bed with nothing to do.
It's been lovely to have you with us, and thank you very much indeed. Cheering up the morning. And thank you, too, for joining us this morning, Andrew and Ned and I, and also for supporting the team up in air. I hope you'll join us on Monday. We're on another Breakfast Time Out roadshow. See you then, I hope. Have a lovely holiday. Bye-bye.
Later this morning, the BBC television outside broadcast cameras will be on the golf course at Fulford in Yorkshire for coverage of the start of the 1984 Benson and Hedges Open Championship. That begins at 10:55 this morning. And now on BBC One, it's time for Cartoon Adventure with Tarzan, Lord of the Jungle.
An Now let's take a look at the lineup of children's programmes for the rest of this morning on BBC One. In a moment, there's a cartoon with Barney Bear, followed at 9.30 by Look Back with Noakes. John and Shep review their adventures in Nelly the Car. At 10 o'clock, the question is, anyone for cricket? With the answer being provided in The Amazing Adventures of Morph. The final Why Don't You? With the Scottish Gang is at 5 past 10. And at 10.30, Carol Leader and Ben Bazell will be opening up the doors of Play School. And that's Friday morning on BBC One. Which continues now with a cartoon tale about the bear that couldn't sleep.